Ken, I phoned somebody and asked him to come over, so when he arrives, will you please...
Well, Bob, I think he's here already. Is this who you were expecting?
Hello, Bob. Walter Pidgeon. Wow.
Walter, I'm glad you got here. I need your help.
What's wrong, Bob?
Well, I have to make an impression on a certain girl who's here this evening.
Oh, I see.
Now, I'm being very honest with you, and I want you to be very honest with me. What can I do to make her think I'm a polished, sophisticated gentleman?
Go home at once.
Walter, I was depending on you. You're the very symbol of culture and refinement. Can't you help me?
Bob, it's no use. I can't make a silk purse out of a sow's ear.
You leave my...
Leave what?
You leave my nose out of this. Almost had my foot on your laugh there, too.
Bob, it takes time to become a real gentleman. Years of background and experience. I've been places, seen things. I've flung wide the portals of life.
Gee, and I even have trouble opening transoms.
You just don't seem to understand. Now, the first essential of culture is education. Now, in my case, everything I happen to know, I learned from many hours of sitting at the tree of knowledge.
I've learned quite a bit hanging from a branch in Griffith Park. Look, Walter, I don't see why I can't be like you. After all, we're both men.
True, very
true.
We're
both made in the same mold.
Yes, Bob, but you remained a little moldy.
If I was a man, I'd resent that.
Well, I'll sell you some ice if you like.
I'll be right up. I'm quite willing to learn, Walter. How should I act around a girl so she'll think I'm sophisticated?
Well, it's a delicate thing, Bob. You must strike a happy medium between formal dignity and easy graciousness.
Huh?
Do you know that that you're rated in society by the label in your suit? Look what the label in my coat says. Created by Bond Street.
Gee.
What does yours say?
Reconditioned by the Salvation Army.
By the way, Bob, who is this girl that you're trying so hard to please?
Oh, she's wonderful. She's lovely. And, oh, look, here she comes now.
Hello, Bob.
Oh, hello, Ingrid. This is Walter Pidgeon.
Oh, how do you do, Walter?
Ingrid Bergman.
Yeah.
This is a moment beyond my wildest dreams. I'm one of your most ardent admirers.
Thank you. I'm glad I had this opportunity to meet you.
Yeah.
You know, you're my... you're my very favorite actress.
You are my favorite actor.
Thank you, Ingrid.
Thank you, Walter.
Every night is the loneliest night in the week.
What are you doing here, Walter?
Well, I've been...
Walter came over to try and convince you that I'm one of the best leading men in the business. Isn't that so, Walter?
Well, to be perfectly honest...
Who asked you to be honest? Just tell her your... Just tell her your opinion of me as a leading man.
Well, Ingrid, I think that Bob turns in a great performance.
Oh, you do?
Yes, a great performance. I think it's remarkable the way he goes around town acting like an actor.
That pigeon is going to be a dead duck in a minute. Ingrid, I'm telling you that I'm the leading man for you.
Well, I don't know.
I do, Ingrid. You've always had the same type of man in your picture, and I think I'd make a wonderful change. You don't want a man who looks like every other man.
No, but she wants some resemblance.
Excuse me, Walter. You can see I'm having a little trouble now. How do you think I should handle her?
Well, Bob, with a woman like Ingrid, the sophisticated approach, it's all wrong. Take my word for it. Whether she knows it or not, she'd go for a man that was rough and tough.
Rough and tough, huh?
Uh-huh.
I think I better make another phone call. By the way, Walter, have you got a nickel?
Sorry, Bob. I've only got a $5 bill.
Oh, that's all right. I have change. Gee, I hope this guy's home.
And now, man, yours to command and ours to present. Here's that rhythm queen you've asked for, Ella Mae Morse.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you very much. Here's a novelty tune dedicated to Private First Class Leroy Preston at APO 689 to the boys of RMO Navy 3205, the Royal Order of Dits and Does, and to Seaman First Class John Battles, Trigger Riddle, and the boys on their LST somewhere in the Atlantic. I hope you like it, fellas. It's Captain Kidd.
There was a guy guy who sailed the ocean. He used to make a big commotion, doing the things the law forbid. The character was known as Captain Kidd. He'd sink a boat to get the jewelry. He wouldn't stand for no tomfoolery. Nobody found the loot he hid. A lucky buccaneer was Captain Kidd. He used to mate with the skull and bone. To him it was a merry prank. And just to get a laugh from Davy Jones, he made his rival boogie woogie off the plane. He got his kick from playing pirates, carried a gun and liked to fire it. Thought he was smart for what he did, but he was only kidding, Captain Kidd. You'll never find his name up in the Hall of Fame. It was the strangest mystery of history. He never got nowhere being a hip corsair. But here's a clue to how he met his Waterloo. One day he went and found a honey. She took the boy for all his money. So after that, he flipped his lid and finished up the tale of Captain
Solid Gap.